Hello, and welcome to the Halloween Super Show Part 2 for 2018. It's Jay Patrick. The rest of the crazy crew will be coming around in just a couple of minutes. Thanks for coming back and checking out Part 2 of the Halloween Super Show. If you like what we do here at Podcast Roll, and you love the holiday season, and you love the Halloween season, because in my mind, Halloween is really the beginning of the holiday season, then do us a favor, do us a solid. Go to Apple Podcast, subscribe, hopefully you've already done that, but rate and review the show. Give us a 5-star rating at Apple Podcast. I say Apple Podcast because that's really the only one I'm smart enough to look up and read. So go to Apple Podcast. You can do it right there on your phone, on your Apple product, and rate and review the show. Podcasts are all. You already listen. So go ahead and give us a 5-star review. If you hear some rain in the background, I decided to do a little something different with this intro. And so I'm actually outside. It's late at night. It's in October. It's dark. It's misty. The rain is falling from the trees. You can hear the drip drip of the rain coming through the gutters on the house. I'm trying to set the Halloween mood for you. And what would be creepier than a creaky door opening right about now? That door leads to a very quiet garage. A dimly lit garage with a single space heater in the corner providing warmth on the cold October night. That's the space heater. And I'm actually sitting down and preparing for you the Halloween Super Show Part 2. Before we get into the show, there's something you need to know. And I think you'll know who I'm talking about when you get into the show. Someone was really enjoying their pumpkin spice latte spirits on Halloween. So this episode, or this part of the episode, I'm not going to say it goes off the rails, but, you know, it gets a little wacky. There's some talk about licorice. There's some Adam's Ghost, where we travel to Asia. There's real life horrible stories. There's talking over each other. There's laughter. It's a super show. And the pumpkin spice latte really kicks in about halfway through this episode. So, thanks for coming back. I hope you enjoyed. Oh, before we get started, I have to, once again, thank Mel for stopping by. You can find her on Twitter at Music City Mel. Check out the show, Two Dead Chicks, The Walking Dead podcast. Fantastic show. If you love The Walking Dead, even if you don't like The Walking Dead, or you moderately like The Walking Dead, you're going to enjoy the podcast, Two Dead Chicks. Go check that out wherever fine podcasts are found. And she's back on. She joins Adam and myself and special guest Josh, formerly of the podcast Collection Connection. So here we go. The Halloween tradition, the fall favorite, the October classic, the Halloween Super Show 2018 Part 2 begins right now.
AdamandJP.com.
Right now.
Exploring the multiverse of pop culture.
This is Pod Casserole.
An Adam and JP show.
And we're back.
All right, and cut.
It's the same cast from last week.
Yeah.
So go listen to Super Show Part 1.
Yeah.
You'll meet everybody. So where we're going to pick this up, because I just stopped.
She was just telling us a story about things she used to do.
Okay.
Well, you know.
Minus
the Peppa Pig Rooker.
Here we go.
Has nothing to do with Michael Rooker either, okay?
Yes,
okay.
It does. Everything to do with
like
Michael
you.
Rooker.
Sorry. You think that's crazy? She should wait till she tells you her Carl story.
Oh, man. That's legal now, right?
Yeah. What's his name in real life?
I'm going to know. What's Carl's real name?
Chandler Riggs.
Chandler Riggs.
Chandler Riggs. Yes.
So PR.
Yes, I used to do PR for a paranormal radio show. Mm-hmm. And so we used to have the guys from Ghost Adventures on, people like that. But I usually was not a part of the show until one day. They had a psychic medium on and they were like, hey, you know, you've not been a part of any of the shows. Would you want to do a reading? And I was like, I'm not really a believer. Sure. Whatever. Fine. So, a friend of mine had actually recently passed away, but nobody would have known that. That's not something I'd advertise by any means. And, this lady, she says that there's a young man coming forth. He's about, he's in his early 20s. But he's not calling you Melissa. He's calling you Millie.
Mm, oh, that's a deep cut.
That's high school. That's, and I was like, oh, shit. And wow. So she described exactly what this person looked like. And I had some questions about how that person had passed away. I won't go into great detail.
Was this 06, 07, 08-ish? What year are we talking here?
Yeah.
I'm trying to. Okay. Yeah, I know where you're going. I got you. Yeah.
And so I had some questions because there was just a lot of things that just didn't add up. And so it bothered me. I thought about it a lot. And she said, he wants you to know that he did it, that it wasn't anything to do with anybody else. There was nothing weird about it. I mean, she described what he wore.
Really?
Yes.
Because I know exactly what
you're talking. I know exactly what you're talking. Yep, yeah. You know.
Wow.
She described the Hawaiian shirt. Wow. She described everything.
Wow.
How did this
it was
screw you
so
up?
It wow. did. I mean,
okay. Like, there's no way.
Wow.
It was. I will never do that again. It was. I mean, it, like.
Was she
it
on the phone or she in studio there?
On the phone.
Really?
Yes.
Really?
I wasn't even in the room. I went to my office. I'm sitting in the floor, literally just crying because I'm like, I can't believe that this is happening right now.
Wow.
She would have had no idea. She could have never known. And these people didn't know anything about me from high school and stuff, and know like that was my nickname or anything like that. So, yeah, it was intense. Wow. So I am a believer, but I don't want none about it.
Yeah,
I'm good.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Pretty
That's
crazy.
Pretty wow. Huh.
Yeah, I can't
Sorry,
top that
like,
story.
I just brought this, I brought the mood down.
No. That's not bringing it down.
No.
The thing about it is, we went to a magic show one time, and it was at TPAC. This is going to sound so stupid.
Was it David Copperfield?
And could have been. But no, seriously, TPAC had this, I guess we thought it was going to be a play. It was not a play at all. It was nothing more than 3 to 4 illusionists slash...
Is it Doug Henning?
Yeah, that's who it was. But this one guy steps on stage and he says that he didn't say that he was a medium. He said something like a sensitive? Is that such a thing?
Yeah,
sure. Yeah. Yeah. Adam's very sensitive.
Exactly. So, but he said, like, he was standing there and he said, I want y'all to think of such and such and an animal. And, like, he started pointing at people and calling out their animals' names. And he goes, oh, hold up. And he points up to this little girl that's, like, 12 who stood up in the balcony. He's like, yeah, your cat's Fluffy. That's who you were thinking of. She was like, yeah. And she sat back down, and we were like, this isn't planned. This is for
real.
Yeah.
Like, and it really messed me up pretty good for a good couple hours. Because I was thinking to myself, there's no way he planted that many people.
Nope.
This was a room full of 2,000 people plus, and just random people standing up, and he's calling them all out. And there's no way this little 11 to 12 year old stood up and was playing in on the thing. It was legit, and he tried to explain how he knew these things, but it didn't really make sense to us. So I mean, I totally believe what you're saying, Melissa. I mean, it's absolutely. I think there's a legitimateness. I can't say that. It's legitimate.
Too legit to quit.
Yeah, just say that.
Yeah.
It's legit.
Legitimateness would be less legitimate.
Or just, okay. Just illegitimate. Can we just say illegitimate?
No.
How about that word?
But he was trying to say it was very legitimate.
It was very legitimate.
It's
because
too legit.
That's the thing, is that you get a kid involved that's that age.
Yeah.
They don't play into those type of things. Or if they do, it looks very skeptical. You'd be skeptical about it.
Yeah.
I'd be very skeptical.
There was an old TV show. The guy's name was John Edward. Do you guys remember him?
Yeah.
He was Crossing kind of Over?
Same idea. Yeah. It was like, you know, 100-ish people in the crowd in a circle, and he would point out randos, which I believed it was random. They would stand up confused and shocked and say stuff like you guys described. So I think, I don't know. I mean, you've seen yourself. It's
Man.
Well, I think when you're involved like that and you have you've told no one any clues or anything like that, and that happens, you can't deny it.
And the fact that you show up, obviously, skeptical, mm-hmm. and then something like that happens, that's what messes you up worse, is that the fact that you're skeptical and you're like, there's no way that this person knows. And then when they state something true, you're screwed up.
What about your paranormal experience?
I don't have any. I wish. I mean, and that's, and that kind of, it sounds bad, but I'm one of those anti-skeptics. Like, I totally believe it all, so much so I want to be a part of that so I can have something to back it up.
I want to be where the people are.
Because he's a total skeptic.
I
total.
We should go on a ghost hunt.
Boom.
I have.
You should, yeah. Well, like a real one.
Like
a real.
Have you had
a public cemetery.
Huh?
You've had an experience?
No.
Oh, yeah, at Carton.
Well, I mean, there were some coyotes in there.
No.
Well, we did hear gunfire.
Yeah, and you swore that something cold touched your ankle.
That was just Michael Rooker.
Oh, dang it, you beat me to it.
There we go.
It was right there with the Mary
Full
Poppins.
Full circle, baby.
Here we go.
Right there with it. Right there.
No, I heard somebody whistling.
But you said that you felt a coldness.
Something just fell over there.
Wait. You said that you felt a coldness when you walked past the grave sites and that something grabbed your ankles.
I never said that.
Oh, that sounds great. I haven't heard that.
Go back
like
and
it.
Find the footage.
I haven't heard
you
that, but
in
I like
Brooklyn?
It.
Do you remember me ever saying something grabbed my ankle?
Tell me the story.
I want to know about this.
Y'all
build onto that.
What?
Huh?
Nothing.
Build onto that.
We did hide.
Yeah. From a car.
Yeah.
And the exhaust made you hallucinate.
Possibly.
Okay.
Oh, I do remember the coldness part. Now they grabbed my ankle.
When you walked past, you felt coldness on your ankles as you walked past all of these tombstones.
That's different than something grabbing my ankle.
Well, look.
Night of the Living Dead.
Let's not get into technicalities here.
Yeah, let's not question.
That's kind of a big detail.
The legitimacy of this.
Okay.
Now, would we all be interested in, like, you pay a few bucks a night and stay in one of those actual haunted old asylums or an old rundown?
JP has.
You two would never do it.
I would like to do that.
I've stayed in a haunted house.
Yes.
I would like to do that.
Bed and breakfast?
Yeah.
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 I would like
that,
to.
That multiple people experienced
horrific
paranormal
stuff.
Activities.
And I said, put me in that room.
Yes.
You know what happened?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Jeez. Would you ever do that? Like,
if I was with other people and I didn't have to be by myself, I would do it.
Once I went to bed and turned off the light, I was starting to question the decision that I'd made.
Really?
But then nothing happened.
But that's just in your head.
Yeah, I would
right?
never, ever sleep. That's for sure. I mean, I'm, you know.
Oh, God, no.
No, yeah.
No.
I'm trying to find. I saved like an actual picture of somewhere around here, an old actual rundown asylum. And for $35 a night, you can spend the night there for 12 hours. And
there's one in
that
Kentucky.
Is a great scam.
No. Yeah. There's an asylum in Kentucky.
What's the name of that one? I know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
What is it, JP? We were supposed to go.
I have
Jack Daniel's Distillers.
That is not true.
Yes,
but it's
I will
okay.
go there.
I will go there.
I volunteer.
No, there's
tribute.
One in Kentucky that we were all going to go to. It's going to be me, you, Brooke, and Mariah. We're going to go up there and spend the night.
Kentucky Downs.
Nope, that's not true. That is the place where the horses race.
Adam?
Well, there's a different one I found in Shelbyville, where the locals say Shelbyville.
Shelbyville.
It's just called the Haunted Hospital. It's an actual old rundown hospital. Ooh. It's not your classic haunt with actors and stuff. It's just you walk through an old dilapidated haunted hospital, and that's $12 a person. No, it's not an all-nighter. It's your, you know, take your time doing a tour, but it's free reign to do what you want, where you want, when you want. Shelbyville.
Okay.
Shelbyville. Yeah. You can do what you want.
How far is old Shelbyville from here? An hour? Everything's like an hour.
It's about
an hour. Yeah.
Hour 15.
Shelbyville?
Yeah.
Shelbyville. It is called Waverly Hills Sanatorium. It is in Louisville, Kentucky.
Ah.
There are paranormal tours every weekend.
How much are those?
This is not the one that I was thinking of. There's one that they feed you dinner and breakfast, and you spend the night, and it's $95 a person. That is not this one.
It's a dead and breakfast. I like it.
They feed you finger food.
I will have to look at finger food, so he says. I do not know how much this one
is. You put your hand into a, like, they say it's eyeballs, but it's just got grapes.
Yeah.
And then spaghetti, and they say it's guts.
Yeah.
Why are you looking that up?
Then you bob for apples.
Let's pick Melissa's brain for a bit for hard stuff.
Okay.
We've spoken all of our favorite things and doodahs. What's that?
First of all, was the paranormal, was it a radio show or was it an internet show?
It was like an internet radio show.
Okay.
Yep.
Do you mind saying what it was?
I can't even remember the name. I can't even remember what it was called. It was a long time ago. But it was, I can tell you, the hosts were Anna and Brian.
Yeah.
Anna Marie and Brian.
Them.
Yeah. Shut up.
Favorite Halloween candy? Go. What you got?
Ooh, smarties.
You're a smart ass. Kit Kats.
Okay, good choice. Favorite horror movie?
Halloween.
Okay, nice. Are you going to see the new one coming out?
Yeah.
That was...
Yeah.
You balked a little bit.
Yeah, no, I'm good. No, see, it's the whole jump scare thing.
Right?
So, yeah,
it's cheap,
I don't love going.
Cheap.
Yeah, I don't love going to the theater because they pump the volume up to like 1,000. Right. I'm like, I'm good.
All right, here's the question. Let's see how much you know about that. The original Michael Myers mask is a cast of whose face?
William Shatner.
Oh, holy shit.
No.
And she said.
It's John Denver.
No.
That Don John Denver's full of shit. All right.
Don John Denver.
Don John Bobby. Is that what that is?
Oh, Long Johnson. Isn't that what that cat says?
Oh, Long Johnson.
Oh, Long Johnson. Why, Aisha? That is so damn scary.
I'm pumped for the new Halloween.
All right.
Yeah. I mean, Jamie Lee Curtis. Hello.
Right, yeah.
Hey, so here's the deal. Everybody loves Halloween.
Welcome to Here's the Deal with Josh.
Here's the Deal with Josh.
Yeah.
Everybody loves 1 and 2.
Yeah.
This takes place after 1. They canceled 2.
Right. This is the third official movie titled Halloween. Isn't that weird?
But here's the thing. Why would they cancel 2? 2's great.
Because the whole sister thing.
Yep.
That's when they had the revelation was his brother, his sister in part 2.
So I watched this recently. Carpenter is one of the main producers, was not the director, but was one of the main producers on 2.
Mm-hmm.
But he disagreed with her being his sister.
Right, yeah.
Why? Why would he sign off on it if he disagrees with that?
The 70s were a crazy time.
Oh, okay. LSD.
From what I gather at that point, it was a money thing. He was doing a lot of other movies, his own style.
Cocaine's
and he kind of
drug.
Put his own. I think to use the characters he had before, he had to put his producer name on there. Much like Stan Lee is a producer for Marvel movies now.
Right.
He doesn't know where he had lunch last, let alone
that's
what's happening
true.
In the new Thor movie. You know?
That's fair.
Yeah. Well, that's not very nice.
Oh, it's very true, though. I'm sorry.
Oh.
It's true.
We've got the question that will stump her.
What?
What is Halloween?
I didn't know this was like part of the show, but
Stone Melissa. All right,
what
Josh.
Is Halloween an unofficial sequel to? What horror film is Halloween an unofficial sequel to?
I definitely have no idea.
Y'all both know this.
Definitely don't know.
Don't know?
No.
Adam.
Black Christmas.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
it's creepy.
So the word on the street is that John Carpenter is good friends with the director of Black Christmas with Margot Kidder.
Okay.
He goes up to him and says, if you were going to do he says, you need to do a sequel to Black Christmas. The director of Black Christmas says, no, Black Christmas is absolutely a standalone film. John Carpenter says, okay, hypothetically, if you were going to do a sequel to Black Christmas, what would you do? He said, I would base it around another holiday. John Carpenter takes the idea, runs with it, and the killer from Black Christmas is supposedly the same as Michael Myers. Hmm. Here's the only problem.
He speaks a lot.
The killer from Black Christmas actually talks, but you never see his face. Obviously, Michael Myers never talks,
right.
But you also never see his face. So that's the word on the street.
True. So watched it this past week again.
Black is Christmas. It not good?
It's good. Yeah, it holds up.
It's my favorite Wham! Christmas song, too.
It is.
Last Christmas.
Black last thing, you know. Yeah. But it's very dirty. The first 5 minutes, he's
Gosh.
On the phone, like saying things
Dude,
he'll do. Like,
what does he
74?
Say? He says some bad stuff.
Yeah, I'll repeat it, but it's like very. It's very
like it's,
yeah.
Oh, Josh will.
Yeah, I will. I'll dance like
it,
Negan
it would
and
never
repeat
happen
all
today,
of
this. You think this is like this
I
is
don't
5
even know
years
Negan
after Woodstock?
Like
it's
that.
Crazy. Yeah. It's good, though.
Do you have any other questions?
No, I was trying to pick the brain on Halloween stuff.
Yeah. What's your favorite Halloween candy?
Mine?
Is it candy corn?
No.
Like when you
put
it up
like... I will
tell
you this. Speaking on the realm... y'all suck. Speaking on the realm of candy for Halloween, I believe a candy that never gets recognized at Halloween, but should be...
We will get there eventually.
Yeah, but should be a huge part of Halloween would be licorice. And licorice never gets brought up at Halloween.
Nope, no thanks.
Where are you from?
It is a freaking black candy that should be for sure a part of Halloween.
Wow.
I'm a Jägermeister fan. I can't do black licorice. People always say it's the same thing. And
Wait. You drink Jägermeister but can't eat licorice?
I don't get the same flavor from those. I don't know why.
That's not true.
No,
I don't get the same flavors at all.
Okay.
So where does your love of licorice come from?
I love lamp. I'm sorry. I love lamb.
It started for me in Wayne's World. Whenever he had his Garth had the mirthmobile and he had the licorice dispenser on the roof of his car. Remember that?
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
I thought it was so
cool. Wait a minute. You like licorice?
I like a red licorice. Black can suck it.
Yeah, black can suck it.
That's wrong.
Yeah. That's true. You know. like licorice is good, but when you have to put the black additive in there, what is that flavor? Is that its own flavor? Like black lip, they created it for that candy?
They said a long time ago.
What's the actual flavor to that?
First off, I used to buy Blackjack gum because it was licorice flavored gum.
Ah, the old Blackjack and T-Berry. Remember T-Berry?
T-Berry.
I used to love some T-Berry gum.
I swear you grew up in like an alternate earth.
It's possible.
That's the Cracker Barrel standby, the Blackjack and T-Berry. Yeah.
Yep. I was good friends with a guy named Barry. Barry Allen.
Jack.
So anyway. Where are you going with this? I'm just going to let you go.
So here's the deal. I used to really like Blackjack gum, and I was a huge licorice fan.
Yeah.
But it just...
Do you like Jägermeister? That's the ultimate question.
I can drink Jägermeister. Yeah. It was developed as a cough syrup.
Was it really?
Did you know that?
I didn't know that.
That checks out.
Huh. It's true.
That's the first real liquor I drink.
Oh,
it's not liquor.
You.
It's whatever it is.
It's malt liquor, ooh. Maybe.
You must have my... At cons, I would have the mana potion bottle around my neck. Remember that? Yeah, it was pretty cool.
Do you still own that?
Yeah, it was a glass mana bottle.
That's cool, the word you want to use.
I would call it my Jaeger mana. I need mana.
Yeah. He wouldn't even say that prior to drinking.
Oh, I remember.
Surprised I got married.
And then he filled it full of...
that's kind of awesome.
He filled it full of Juggalo juice.
Oh, my God.
Did you say jungle or Juggalo juice?
Juggalo.
Oh, wow.
And then he filled it full of brownie juice. Clearly.
Yeah, I can't believe you snuck off that one convention and went to that brownie party.
That's a lie, by the way.
That is not a lie.
He had a hoof mark on his ass. I'm telling you right now, it's true. All right.
You said you went to the brownie party.
All right, so
the party? Oh, the party. I thought you said the con. Yeah.
No, the brownie party.
I go to all the parties. Check them
all out. You did go to the brownie party.
Yeah.
So the other night.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with it.
That's the fun of multi-fandom conventions is you go up to the room parties.
Yeah.
Well, you have the demonics, you have the juggalos, you have the bronies. You got to test them all out.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
We definitely wound up in a juggalo party.
Yeah, that's the first time I ever had tequila was from a random juggalo. He was mixing drinks, the bartender.
Yeah.
It tastes like dog food.
Had Faygo. That's their drink of choice.
Yeah.
He'd pour it in the drink from the 2-liter itself, make another drink, and put liquor in there. We're like, just taking it. Yeah,
oh, wow.
That was rough.
All right, so the other night we went to Andrew Jackson's home, which is known as the Hermitage.
Welcome to History with Josh.
Exactly. So we went to the ghost tour of this. And can I tell you at the beginning?
What is Andrew Jackson known for?
Being a slave owner? Yeah. I don't know.
Definitely yeah. That.
Are you serious?
No. He was known as, there's a big thing about him being...
That's his big, yeah.
What is the most noteworthy thing Andrew Jackson did?
He was a president?
Okay.
Okay. So here's the deal. We all live, and if you don't know this, we live in Tennessee, and the Hermitage is a place where you go on field trips when you're younger.
Yeah, yeah.
And you also, as an adult, go on a ghost tour, evidently, if you're me. So we went the other night. There was this kid that walked up, and... It didn't ruin the night
in the ghost tour?
No, not at all. It was a ghost tour that was based in just the history of the fact that Andrew Jackson visited the Bell Witch, and most people don't even know who the hell the Bell Witch is.
Really? Oh,
but all of us know that the Bell Witch is the scariest shit around.
Yeah.
So
but now's the point of the show where we get real.
Exactly.
Getting real with Josh.
So we get there, and there is a kid wearing a fucking brony hat. And I don't want to say it ruins the night for me, but it totally takes the punch out of it.
And that's
for
when
me.
You said, Adam, what are you doing here?
I was like, Adam, I didn't know you were coming to this.
Hey, y'all. You want some licorice?
Yeah, exactly. So it doesn't ruin the night for us so much as what do you do when there's a brony kid in your 20 people that are allowed to go through the house in the middle of the night on a ghost tour?
Oh no, was he bothering you?
He wasn't bothering me.
Then
but
you just leave him alone?
He spoke with a lisp and he had a freaking brony hat on and it made it not scary for me
Wait, was it a My Little Pony hat or did it say brony?
No, it was straight up. It had Twilight Princess or whoever one of those guys are.
Sparkle.
The Tara Strong is. Oh, Tara Strong?
Is she?
Twilight?
Yeah, she's Twilight Sparkle, I think.
So
right?
Anyway, it has multiple My Little Pony characters on it, and it just kind of took me out of it. And every time he would ask a question, it was in the lisp, and it just took me out of the scary.
What questions was he asking you?
He was like, so with...
I didn't say do an impression.
No, sorry.
I said, what questions
sorry,
are you
sorry,
asking
so, so he was like, so is that pipe made out of part of the Alamo? Because it was.
Wow.
There was a pipe there that was made out of part of the Alamo. And like he's
so he knew more about the Hermitage than you did. So,
without question.
Wow.
Without question, so he did. Wait, hold on. So we get like all these questions.
We're talking 8 or 15?
No, this kid was at least 16 plus.
Oh, I saw a little boy. Okay.
No. And he had the brony hat on. The part that they tried to scare us the most on was going out to the garden, which is where everybody's buried. And there was no way that was scary at all, except for there is a lady. I say lady.
In a lake?
Yeah, exactly. They pay somebody to set. So they pay somebody to sit out there all night and watch the tomb.
What?
Yeah.
Why?
Wow.
There is a tent outside the garden. They pay someone to sit there to make sure no one does anything to the tomb every night.
Okay. Night. All right. Make sure old Hickory stays in his grave.
Exactly. Well, either that or just to make sure that nobody desecrates anything.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
him and his wife are buried side by side with a almost like a mini Washington Monument in between them.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, they pay someone to sit out there and watch it every single night.
Wow.
That was your nickname in Cub Scouts, right?
What's that?
Mini Washington Monument.
Oh, famous Big Hickory or whatever it was.
Old Hickory?
Yeah,
Big Hickory.
Big Hickory.
Here comes Big Hickory.
Here he comes.
Can we all promise to go to the Bellwitch Cave soon?
It's
like an hour and 15 minutes from here.
I've been to the Bellwitch Cave.
Yeah, but I've never.
No, you haven't been.
Yeah. Same here. All right, we should do it.
So here's a question. We were going to go, and our buddy had knee surgery, and they said, you do not need to bring anyone here who doesn't have like sure footing. Is it slick inside there? Is it like rain?
I'm sure it's pretty rocky.
Water?
Like, not,
is it?
Yeah.
I was in sixth grade.
Oh, never mind.
Yeah, I'm sure it's pretty rocky.
So that was a few years ago.
Had been like recently in the sense of like
last week.
Like you,
yeah.
Never mind.
No. From what I gather, it's pretty rocky. Like the thing is, don't take anything from it. It's a lot of loose pebbles and rocks, so it's probably not too.
And there's a ghost.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, but all right. They also told us that history. Do you know that there's a history between Andrew Jackson and the Bell Witch?
No, but I feel like I'm about to.
Okay.
Here it goes.
All right. I'll make this short because I didn't find it extremely interesting, but besides the fact
short hickory.
That
here we go. Give it to me.
It was big. It was
this old hickory history brought to you by.
Supposedly, it was folklore all around that the Bell Witch was a thing, and Andrew Jackson wanted to go visit. They went to visit. He took some kind of witch talker or witch speaker with him.
I know this sounds so dumb. I want to be a witch talker.
So he's like a witch sewer. What's the word I'm looking for? Like if you a sew speaker,
a soothsayer,
soothsayer.
Well, that's like a fortune teller. But
it's a fortune teller.
But that talks to witches.
Huh? Oh, well, a soothsayer doesn't necessarily talk to witches.
All right, whatever. Andrew Jackson.
A medium.
It wasn't a medium.
Are you sure?
It was a witch tamer is what they called it. So this sounds so dumb. But
coming this fall to CBS. Jennifer Love Hewitt is back.
There it is.
So supposedly Andrew Jackson takes this witch
tamer
whisperer with him.
Jennifer Love Hewitt.
And when they get to her gate, their entourage can't move any farther.
So it's a witch talker?
The best I can find, they're called wanderers. I don't know. Bette Midler.
Right, one of the two. Bette Midler. Do they tame witches? Also Bette Midler.
I don't think so.
Okay.
I don't know. I got
to
go deep.
Well, that's what the way they sold it to us was that this guy could actually tame witches. They said it was a witch tamer.
Who's your favorite witch?
Glinda.
The good witch?
Yeah.
Adam, who's your favorite witch?
The witch.
I just love the Sarah Sanderson.
I was
going to
say.
Yeah. Say Sarah Sanderson. Yeah.
Are you going to watch the special version of Hocus Pocus?
There's a special version?
Yeah, where it's like pop-up video. Where they put
really?
Trivia.
That's kind of cool.
Oh, that's cool.
Huh. Mel, do you have a favorite witch?
Sabrina.
Mine's Marie Laveau.
No, yours is Sabrina.
No, it's Marie Laveau.
Dude, you sure say, you have said on this show that you had a huge crush on...
Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Oh, okay, that's right. Never mind. It's Mike. Mike is the Sabrina lover.
Yes.
That is it.
I started mixing it up, man. I found a shirt on Amazon Fashion. You need Josh. It just says Witch Tamer on it. Witch Tamer.
It says Witch Tamer.
Witch Tamer.
I will absolutely wear that.
Yeah,
next week.
Witch Tamer, it's all yours. It's in like classic third grade spooky font too.
Yeah, that's what
it's
I'm talking
perfect
about.
For you.
Witch Tamer,
bright red.
So, do you want to do Adam's ghost?
We can do it. Yeah,
in Japan.
Is that where we're going?
If you guys want to go to Japan, we're going to Japan.
We're going to Japan. Creepy kids and shit.
Okay.
Which is my third favorite Halloween movie.
Is Creepy Kids and Shit?
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Are we best friends?
Yes. Velociraptors.
Let's take a flight to Okinawa, Japan. Mm. Let's go to Camp Hansen, specifically gate number 3.
Can I honestly say this music messes me up every time?
You don't even hear it, but you can hear
it. No, I can hear the music. It messes me up so freaking bad.
How do you hear it?
Because
I can't hear it, so I don't know what the fuck
y'all play it every freaking time. Sorry. And it messes me up, and you're messing me up right now. Okinawa, Japan, go.
Okinawa, Japan, gate 3 in Camp Hansen. You know, every weekend at night, a soldier.
I'm not playing any music.
Dressed in World War II gear. With blood all over his fatigues, a cigarette in his hand, and he would ask the gate guard the same thing every night. He would say, "Got a light?"
I'm so out.
Usually, the MP would light a cigarette for the soldier. As soon as it was lit, the GI would then disappear.
Mm-hmm. You didn't even have to tell me. I just knew what was coming.
There's an update on this, though.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, we all listen to your old hickory stories.
Dang it. But this freaks me out.
Update, this gate is now closed because of these regular hauntings. They've had problems keeping a Japanese sentry.
There you go.
Like S-E-N-T-R-Y, not century, but sentry at this gate.
Yep.
Because it malfunctioned. So the Okinawa Camp Hansen gate number 3, the Phantom Soldier. When you light a cigarette, dust in the wind like Kansas.
Got a light.
How about?
I'm out.
You don't like that?
No, it's scary as shit.
Really?
It is a freaking...
It's not really that scary.
It's not.
No, it is a
And I'm the wimp here.
Yeah.
Whatever. Okay, I'm good.
How about the outskirts of Tokyo, Japan? Have you guys have played the game Fatal Frame? Any of you heard of the video game Fatal Frame?
No.
Okay. Outside Tokyo is a haunted mansion that was the basis of the game Fatal Frame. It said there are other houses close by. Once again, if you don't know how Adam's ghosts work, I have a crew of researchers across the globe that send me these handwritten notes. They're terrible sometimes. It is said that there are also houses close by linked to the past of the mansion. People who have gone in there were later found by police with rope marks on their wrists, legs, and necks. There are also vast tunnels under the mansion, but it is unknown what they're even for. Sometimes during the day, you can photograph a small girl in a kimono peeping through one of the windows. Mm.
Peeping, you say?
In the outskirts of Tokyo, Japan.
Wait. JP, what sound does she make?
Clearly it.
How about the, Ikego, Yokohama, Japan, the middle gate specifically. Ikego, Yokohama. You know where that is. You guys are know.
Oh, yeah.
You're aware.
I went to summer camp there.
A World War II concentration camp.
I went to summer camp there.
Where thousands of Chinese and Korean people were put to work and killed by the Japanese army. It is now a U.S. military housing base, and there are 5 incinerators that are still active and stand today. It has 3 gates that keep it separate from the Japanese community, the main gate, the middle gate, and a back gate. At the middle gate, gate guards have experienced hearing voices, footsteps, and a feeling of being watched. Some have even reported a World War II Japanese soldier in a brown uniform with no legs. Between the gates.
Got a light.
At the Ikego Yokohama Middle Gate base.
All right, the only reason that doesn't scare me is, did you ever
see... lighting a cigarette did, but a guy with no legs is fine for you?
No, seriously.
The funny thing.
But like, Lieutenant Dan, you ain't got no legs.
But do y'all remember the old kung fu flick where the guy had no legs and the other guy had no arms?
Oh, yeah.
Can you not tell me that's not fantastic? It's not scary. It's funny.
Yeah, I mean... It's my favorite Andrew Jackson story.
Yeah, exactly.
Let's do one more. The Atsugi Naval Air Base in Section
Say
B.
Say that again.
Atsugi Naval Air Base, Section BEQ 985.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
The spirit of a young man is often seen wandering from room to room, believed to be the ghost of a Marine that was killed in a car accident in the 60s.
Got a light?
I have no legs. Got a light? last one in Nagasaki, Japan.
This is going to be bad.
It's also said the souls of the nuclear bomb victims in Nagasaki at the end of World War II haunt the area. Voices pleading for help, crying and screaming can be heard around twilight. It's also said that some of these souls sometimes lurk in the shadows of the living Nagasaki, Japan.
Got a light.
I got choked up there. That was a tough one.
All right, that one would screw me up. Because that one's based, I think anything that's based in reality.
With mass casualty, I mean, it's a lot of, I don't know the numbers, we're talking a lot of death, a lot.
Yeah.
Don't you feel like that based in reality screws you up worse than anything? Like, I can deal with the far-fetched. The based in reality ones are the ones that mess me up the worst.
I was watching a documentary not too long ago, and one of the stories in the documentary was in Japan, and it was years after the tsunami hit. What was that? 2011. Yeah. And so many people lost family members in that tsunami. And this guy wanted to help the families through the grieving process. Mm-hmm. He found an old phone booth and he set up this phone booth. And every day, people come to the phone booth, they pick up the receiver, and they just converse as if their loved one was there to hear them.
That's messed up.
And it's part of the grieving process for them.
It's good, wow. And it scares me all at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
Because to me, those are the most legitimate ones, right?
Yeah.
Agree.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, well, happy Halloween, everybody.
Yeah, Brandon, I was just going to say, to me, yeah, I poke fun at a lot of that stuff, but like what you're talking about is way too legitimate. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like, I feel like that if there were souls hanging around just waiting to write something, that's legit.
It's going
to
be around there for sure.
Right,
yeah.
Right. The tsunami stuff, like, we all watched it on TV. You can't watch it and not in some way be affected, right?
Right. Mm-hmm.
So, therefore, the fact that it affects you also plays to the part that you would buy into the legitimateness of people speaking to loved ones who have been lost in that.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, especially if it helps them through the grieving process.
Right. I think that's what messes me up the worst is feeling like that it's legitimate.
Mm-hmm. The best story was someone who had come two or three times brought his mother, and I guess they lost the father of the family. Mm-hmm. And so he convinced his mother to come, and she was real... She didn't want to do it. She didn't believe it was help. She wouldn't go into it. And then finally, since they'd come all that way, she went in and then just lost it.
Mm.
You know, just having that experience.
So she had that experience where she actually felt like she spoke to someone?
I don't know that they feel like they're speaking. I mean, I'm sure on some level they do feel like they're speaking to their loved ones, but it's not like they're saying they're talking back. It's not paranormal in any way.
Is it one of those
things? It's just a way to express what you would like to say to them.
It's just a release. Mm-hmm. It's just a way to cope.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Still,
and it's become communal because so many people, you know, travel to this one area to go to this phone booth to do it.
Wow. Have you seen the documentary, The Bridge? Have you seen that?
Mm-mm.
It's pretty depressing. It's the Golden Gate Bridge. So, like, the documentarian for a year, two or three, to set up a camera on a tripod and a slow release, and just filmed the bridge. And in the minute he saw someone come up to commit suicide, he would zoom, find out about the person, go to their story, find their family, talk. It's crazy. And there, I mean, wow. I forget the number, but way, 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 way more than you would think jump off that bridge.
Oh, it's span of a year?
A year or two, but it was. I mean, they show a lot. I mean, they don't show the whole deal, where they show the jump and they stop there and kind of freeze it, go to the person's family and find out about the person. It sounds messed up and crazy, and it is, but it's a crazy character study of what causes someone to go to that point. And, you know, before that, no one saw it coming. It's a real person. And, it just made me think about, the bridge, I believe it's called. Yeah.
All right. Okay. If we want to get real in that sense, and granted, it's, you know, this is the Halloween episode, so you kind of have to get to an extent real. We have a bridge that's near us, and you can look it up. It's called the Natchez Trace Bridge.
I saw those numbers recently. That's crazy. Because that one happened a few days ago.
All right. I haven't told y'all this. I saw the one a few days ago.
Are you serious?
What?
Yeah.
Geez. All right. So.
Wow.
So hang on. Are you sure you want to do this?
I do. I do because I think that people will. I think people want to hear this.
Okay.
All right. So here's the deal. So I start driving to work on a random like Tuesday. And as I'm driving to work, I'm talking to my dad. I generally call my parents on the way to work. It's just the time that they're up drinking coffee. I get on my way to work. It's just a time for us to converse. So it made sense that I was talking to my dad, and my dad is usually the one that gives me the perspective in life about chilling out and accepting life for what it is and doing whatever I need to do to deal with life. Okay. So I'm driving to work, and I always drive past this bridge that we call the Natchez Trace Bridge. And you can look it up. It's definitely the biggest land bridge in Tennessee. If not, JP, is it not one of the biggest in the United States, if I'm not mistaken?
I don't know. It's real big.
Okay, as far as land bridges go, like you were talking about the other bridges, it goes over a body of water. This does not go over a body of water. It's one of the biggest land bridges in Tennessee. So I'm driving past, and I happen to notice, and I had been talked to before by police officers that I happen to know, saying that on a regular basis they do have someone jump from that bridge, and generally they clear. This is going to sound bad. These people, usually when they jump off that bridge, they are impaled by the trees on the either side of the bridge. All right, I don't mean to bring things down, but that's generally the case. So I drive past, and I see two cop cars parked over to the left-hand side of the bridge. They have their cameras out, like cell phone cameras out, and they are doing something, and I didn't realize what they're doing. And at this point in time, I'm having my morning conversation with my parents or my dad, just talking to him. And all of a sudden, when we pass, I told my dad, I was like, oh, my gosh. And he was like, what's wrong, son? I saw the body laying there. And look, I'm not trying to freak anybody out. This is just a legitimate thing that happened. I see the body lying there. They're taking pictures of it. They really should have been covering it up way better. They should have had a sheet covering it. They should have had something. And I see this contorted body laying on the ground, and they're taking pictures of it.
Well, they're conducting an investigation.
Yeah, or just morbid curiosity.
No,
I don't know what
the police
doing.
Officers, they yeah, no, it was part of their work. They have state. To document it.
They
it
do.
Was state.
Yeah, they have to document it.
Okay, so I see it, and I kind of freak out, and my dad has to talk me down and just say, son, it's okay. These are things that happen, and it's just you just happen to drive past at this point. And it messed me up for a good part of the day. Because I mean,
absolutely.
Well, you
absolutely
don't expect to see something like that. Mm-hmm. So I come back through about an hour later, and there's multiple cars around it, and there's no way possible that you can see this body. But I actually saw a body that had, I saw the body of someone who had jumped.
Jeez.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Okay. Well, we're
all right.
Bring,
now that I brought it down,
we're going to bring it back up. Yeah. All right, we actually have one of these this week.
Oh, yeah, we do, yeah.
It's the SOBOTW.
Right. It's all of that online interaction, you know, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Is Vine still a thing?
No.
Friendster?
Is it?
MySpace is still good, right?
Snapchat?
Snapchat. Marco Polo's kind of cool these days. You doing Marco Polo?
Mm-hmm. I use Marco Polo,
all the kids
actually.
Are doing it.
Yeah.
So
Marco
Polo. Interact with us on there. Anyway, talk to us, we talk to you, and we'll read off your, possibly your interaction. We have a doozy this week.
Yeah, yeah.
Dude.
We may have to try to translate this.
This in from Okinawa. Witchy Wife 1020 says she's delighted. Wandering around in Castland mediocrity, mostly. Been pleasantly surprised to bump into this beauty. Exceptional content, production second to none. Pretty freaking hilarious, actually. With an upbeat, positive vibe. Refreshing indeed, she says. The usual troll trope glut is yawn, sheeple speak, so your efforts are noted, appreciated, and now anticipated. Stocking up on candy cigs to smoke after a good one, ha. Best wishes and good luck. The Un-Truman Show, a.k.a. Witchy Wife 1020.
Thanks,
is
Witchy Wife.
Is this real life?
Well, is this the last episode before Halloween?
I believe so, yeah.
Hey, can I say that I love the Un-Truman Show?
You let say it.
I do.
The Untrue Man Show.
That's what, I love them.
Okay.
They're my favorite. I don't know them, but I feel
like
I've known
them forever.
I thought
Two Dead Chicks was your favorite.
Oh, yeah.
I thought Two Dead Chicks was your favorite.
That's true.
We haven't given her a bump this episode yet.
Oh, that's true.
You want to give a plug for your podcast?
That was it.
Okay.
The two Dutch. That was it. That's the whole
available
thing.
Now. Two Dutch all fine podcaster fans.
So,
that's true.
I don't wanna,
it is true.
I don't want to get sad again here, but you said the end is nigh for your podcast.
It is.
Do you have the number down? How many you have left? Or do you have?
So however many are left in this season. Oh, really? So what is that? 14-ish?
Really?
I think,
so
yeah.
So no more specials? No.
We might do one last. Yeah. You know, hoorah yeah. with
Hey, you
that.
Talked about your favorite horror movie. What was like the first horror movie you ever saw? How old were you? Do you remember your introduction into horror?
Scream was definitely my first.
Oh, that's
my,
the greatest.
My parents were super, super protective.
Really?
So it took me a while to finally actually get to watch a horror movie, and it was definitely Scream, and my parents definitely scared the shit out of me.
Really?
When I was watching it, I'm like, yeah.
Trying to teach you a lesson,
Yeah. I still have a thing about masks. Like, if you're going to kill me, just take your mask off.
So
I
masks
just
and
know
clowns. You don't like, not a fan, okay.
Like Jim Carrey's the mask?
Ooh. Like,
any of them.
Like Rocky
I don't
Dennis.
Care. Don't care what it is. I don't want to, I want to know, I want to see your face.
Yeah, I got you.
See you.
Okay. Sam Elliott, Rocky Dennis?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice,
Sam Elliott's in A Star Is Born, right?
Yes. Oh my God,
you were excited about that.
What? Yes.
She was pumped for that movie.
Oh,
I know.
That is a remake.
Explain your pumpage.
Of a remake.
Of a remake.
Yeah.
Have y'all seen Bradley Cooper? I know I'm the only girl at this table.
That's
but
what it is, the Bradley Cooper
as
love.
As Jackson Maine.
Okay, that's what the love is. Okay,
delicious.
I got you. I got you.
Mm-hmm. He's great.
Soundtrack came out last week.
Oh, wow. It's so great.
It's really good.
I was literally at like 12:01. Got to listen
to
this.
I know, you were, she was pumped
about
it.
I was on
it. You were,
super pumped, yep.
Now that, I think the little tour that she did when she came to Nashville, was it 2 years ago? Where she was just visiting dive bars and performing very country styled music.
Yes.
I think that was all in preparation for this.
Think so?
Mm-hmm.
That makes sense. Yeah.
Like those crazy, she would do like just little dive bars pretty much. Like you said,
yeah. She'd just show up.
Yeah.
You know that song she did, You and I? I don't know. If, I swear I thought that was Carrie Underwood the first time I heard
really?
It because it's so country sounding. Yeah.
I just realized how creepy social media is. It kills the idea of a class reunion. Like I knew all about her excited for this movie. I haven't seen her in 16 years.
All right. So here's the question. Why does she show up at like drag bars? To perform?
That's her crowd.
That was one of her first jobs.
That's her crowd.
They incorporated that into A Star Is Born.
Okay.
Yeah, she
so
actually
that's part
was
of
one
it?
Of her first jobs. That was one of her first jobs,
okay.
Yeah.
Like, I just didn't understand. Like, to me, like, she throws so many things out there. Like, I don't understand, like, where, I don't know.
That's her crowd.
Is that just it?
Yeah.
That's the monsters?
Yeah.
Little monsters.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think she gives a voice to people that feel like they don't have one. You know
okay,
what I mean?
That makes
and
sense.
I think that, I think she's great. I love her.
It's like Bon Jovi said, this is a song for the brokenhearted. Kind of like that.
Hmm.
I don't think it's anything.
Nope.
What did you call yourself? Long Dong Jovi? Was that what it was?
What?
You said that earlier, right?
Did you say that?
Oh, you said that earlier.
No, I didn't say anything about Bon Jovi.
I don't think you've ever said what your original horror movie was, the first one you
first.
The Shining. We spoke of it last year.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What was
Red Drum?
Yeah.
Mine was Children of the Corn.
Saturday the 14th.
No. Liar.
Really?
No, it was really Saturday the 14th.
That is not true.
What?
That's your first horror film.
Yeah, it was Saturday the 14th.
But it's not a horror film.
Does that count? Well, like horror. Like,
that's comedy.
That's, yeah.
Night of the Living Dead.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll buy that.
Because I remember staying up super late to watch it and being scared. Mm-hmm. And that was probably 10-ish.
Here's one for you. The original Night of the Living Dead is 1968. The remake, 1990. Therefore, more time has passed since the remake between remake and original. Isn't that crazy?
That is wild.
Yeah.
You just blew my mind.
I know, right? Bam.
Mind blown.
So in theory, it's time for another remake.
Not really.
What's your take on horror remakes of classic movies that are remade? What's your take on that? Yay, nay? There's no right answer. Yeah.
I mean, sometimes it's fine.
I'm always excited to see it, but 95% of the time I'm sad about it when I do see it.
You know, I think it was just for TV. I don't remember, but the Rosemary's Baby remake wasn't bad.
I don't think I ever saw
it.
There was a remake.
Wasn't bad. Yeah, it had Zoe Saldana. Is that her name?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Zoe Saldana.
How long ago?
Yeah. Oh. Within the last 5 years.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
It was actually pretty good.
So you said it was made for TV?
I think it was. Oh, wow. Yeah, I think it was. But it was actually pretty good. Very cool. Wasn't bad.
Huh. So where did your zombie love begin? Did you like the Romero stuff?
No.
What?
I kind of just got bamboozled into watching the show. I did not want to watch it.
Uh-huh.
And it was finally, it was like season 3. And I was like, you know, oh, fine, I'll watch it. And then now here I am.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So have you gone back and watched like the classic
Mm-mm.
zombies
Mm-mm.
movies?
Mm-mm.
Shaun of the Dead?
No.
Shaun of the Dead.
And I mean, to be fair.
World War Z.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I've watched these, but like, I mean, it's not necessarily my thing. I'm more in The Walking Dead for the like the relationships and the rebuild of society.
Rick
and
Schoen.
There's a difference.
I've been telling you this for years.
I know, but from day one, I've said there's the difference. Or people.
Oh, Adam loves the chick flicks.
No, the exact.
It's not he does. A chick flick.
It's the Notting Hill of zombie films.
But I've told you since day one that is a show for people. That's my point.
The Notting Hill of zombie films. Tell the truth.
The Walking Dead?
Yeah.
No. I think Fido. Have you seen Fido? It's more like that.
Yeah.
It's like that. No. Warm Bodies. Fantastic movies. Romeo and Juliet of zombie movies. Watch
I do
that
like
again.
That one.
Watch
fun.
That a few days ago again. It's a good one.
That's fun.
It's a good movie.
It is fun.
Well, that was a good show.
Do you remember Marvel Zombies?
Yeah, I have
a remember when that was like a craze?
I have quite a few of those, yeah.
Yeah, the Marvel Zombies.
Guy multiple times. Sidum, what's his name? The guy who does the Marvel Zombies.
I don't know.
He's been at Dragon Con every time.
Really?
Okay. I believe
something,
you.
Something Sidum.
There's lots of people at Dragon Con.
It's okay.
2014, NBC had a 4-hour Rosemary's Baby miniseries. I believe you.
Is that the
curious.
One that was with the
Zoe Saldana?
Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah.
Never
it was
that
good.
That was 2014?
Yeah.
So yeah. That was right before Guardians.
Yeah. Post-Star Trek before that, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I was going to say Star Trek was before that.
Wow.
What's the first movie that you remember seeing in a theater?
89 Batman.
Okay.
Yeah.
First movie ever?
Uh-huh.
Twister.
Really?
Oh, that's
oddly
a good one.
Enough.
Josh.
It's from Rocky 3.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Good choice. You?
The original Superman movie.
Oh, really?
Mm. Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
It's the first movie that I have any sort of memory.
That's the only Superman movie I recognize.
Yeah. The original Superman movie?
Mm-hmm. Donner.
Yeah.
Do you like Twister, the movie now?
It's fine.
Okay. I'm trying to see everyone, because all the ones we've named, where we kind of like still. So I was curious.
Yeah, it's
okay.
Fine.
Okay.
I loved Twister when it first came out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
I haven't seen it in years.
Yeah. Yeah. I owned it, I think, twice on VHS.
Did the effects hold up? Because I remember being, no pun intended, blown away.
Yeah.
Hey, when it came out.
I feel like they're not bad.
Except for the cow. The cow could
be bad, yeah.
I actually attended Universal Studios.
That's great.
With two different things that have been gone since then. I saw the Ghostbusters in the same place that the Twister was.
Yeah. Mm.
And I got to see both of them in the same
building,
whatever. So when they ended the Ghostbusters thing where you got to see the whole life-size Stay Puffed, they made it into Twister where a cow went flying. Huh. And I got to see both of them.
Huh.
Now it's Jimmy Fallon.
Yeah.
This is
really gay shit.
I've done the Twister stuff.
What?
Wow.
Sorry, Ed, that was not a slur. That was just literally, I hate it. It was just part of me.
You don't like Jimmy Fallon?
I'm sorry.
Not a Jimmy
no,
Fallon?
Barely not.
No, here's the deal. Like, have you seen
Damn.
It? It's a 3D thing with him in this 3D car that doesn't make any sense.
Is that like, what's his name? Drew Carey's 4D stuff that was there for a while?
I fell asleep during
it's
that.
It's bad.
Same here. That's terrible.
It's
that was
bad. Like,
it's
like I took a nap.
That was
it's
like
not
ASMR
good.
Before
it's
ASMR.
Not good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's not good. Have you seen
it? Did Jimmy Fallon?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've done it.
It's not good. Ooh.
Hey, you guys should do an ASMR podcast.
It's him
that stuff
racing
yet?
Around
no?
the New
ASMR?
New York.
No?
Yeah.
No. Look it up.
In a space
okay.
car.
All right.
Is that not true?
Yeah.
What?
Space car.
What space
New
car?
York City.
Yeah, I didn't know
yes.
Podcast
okay.
over that.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Do it. Yeah.
The what? What did we just decide? We have like three conversations going on here.
There's the new thing like on what? Streaming and YouTube called ASMR. It's the whispering and talking slowly and you'll brush your teeth.
Oh,
you'll brush your teeth quietly.
That chick that eats pickles.
Yeah, it's called.
It's wrong.
Wait,
it's wrong.
You have
is that a thing?
Josh, would you like to eat a pickle?
Nope.
It's,
nope.
I feel
like
that
like,
should
it's
happen.
It's like cold pickles, and it's like
yeah. But about 65% of people
so bad.
Have these things called their tingles.
Nope, it's wrong.
So when you have that, you start tingling these ASMR tingles.
Nope, there's no
certain
tingles
in the back of your head.
It is disgust.
Yeah, you make it sound.
Yeah,
it's wrong.
Pickle sexual, but it's not.
Yeah,
did
the
he just say pickle sexual?
Tell
me the
truth. I knew that was a thing.
By the way, he say pickle sexual.
That was Josh's nickname in Cubs.
Pickle, yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
Cub Scouts, yeah. Pickle sexual.
Josh.
That checks
oh, it's
out.
Wrong.
It's wrong.
It's wrong.
All right. Yeah. Well, any we final go. Halloween thoughts, Adam?
Pickle sexual.
I think that's about.
I don't think we can do anything else.
Yeah.
Wow.
Has the once you're ending the show of Two Dead Chicks, is that kind of? Are you burnt on zombies or horror stuff from now on? Or what do you
She's
what
not.
Do you think?
No, yeah. I am not. In fact, I'm maybe joining. It looks like I'm joining as a like at least part time co-host for the Horror Returns, which
oh,
is based
nice.
Out of Texas.
Nice.
So love
nice.
My Texas boys.
Nice.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah.
That'll be fun.
Yeah. Nice. Oh, they're great. So if you guys haven't checked them out, you would like them.
I'll check them
fantastic.
Out.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool.
Josh, any final Halloween thoughts?
Yeah, I'm kind of scared right now.
I miss Josh podcasting weekly.
I do too. I wish Josh would come back.
I don't really well. Know what y'all talking about.
just,
this is the first
the,
time.
The
this is the first time I've ever been on a podcast. ever.
I can't tell. You're a natural. Hey, January 2019, yeah. First episode of The Old Hickory Chronicles with Josh.
It's true.
Thick Hickory starring Josh.
Thick Hickory. Thick Hickory starring Josh.
Or just Thickery. Yeah. With Josh.
True.
Boy.
Like Thackeray Binks. It's close. Yeah. From,
Thackeray Binks.
Oh, Thackeray.
All right, Adam, this is it. This is the last Halloween episode.
I know. Until
I love you, boys.
June of next year? Yeah. We start earlier each year.
Though we're still going to do the long Halloween, right?
We're doing some stuff. Yeah.
So we'll take a little Batman Halloween break.
Huh? Yeah, pretty much, Batman? Yeah. You know, it's copyright.
No, we decided we enjoy doing this sort of stuff so much.
I'm going to stretch it out. I mean,
into November?
Conspiracy theories, ghost stories. Who doesn't like that?
That's fun.
Yeah.
A couple of times a month.
Yeah. Can you bring up those stones in Georgia with the blood on top of them?
What?
The Georgia Guidestones?
Yeah, that's
we've talked about it before, right?
We've done that.
Yeah.
Anything else we've done before you want to
do? I want to do those again.
Thanks for listening.
Okay, I love you.
You're the Untruman Show, aren't
yes,
you?
I am.
What about a rundown of the whole witchcraft series? Yeah. All 13 installments.
You know? No.
Starring Mike
Draw
Dudley.
The line.
Yeah. Look those up. Look up witchcraft.
Do you know what?
Put your adult filter on and then just do it. Look it up.
The idea I hated when I first heard about it that now actually intrigues me, and I want to listen to a podcast that does this. That takes a movie and goes minute by minute.
Oof. Yeah.
Like each episode is 1 minute of the movie.
Yeah. Oof. I'll never listen.
No.
But think about the discussion you would be forced to have.
Think of all
you
the,
can only talk about 1 minute.
Yep. Think of all the ums and uhs and
ahs.
You welp.
And yeah. All those pauses.
That sounds rough. I don't think I love any.
That's like a normal show for us anyways.
I don't love any media that much to break down minute per minute. I couldn't do it.
Not even if it was Killer Clowns from Outer Space.
I mean, that's a lot of...
Texas Chainsaw Massacre?
I don't think... Because even that first 30 minutes, a slow movie. I'll admit that. And then so there's like a five-minute scene where they're in a van just driving, talking. So we have five episodes of like, yeah. And the window's right there, and there's the smoke of the exhaust.
I mean, well, I don't think that's what you do. I think you use most of the time to give insight about the making of the film and that sort of thing.
So it's an episode per minute?
Mm-hmm.
That means like 90 to 100 episodes per movie.
That's a lot.
Mm-hmm. Or that Jaws. Is, there's one about Jaws, and it's over 2 hours.
No. That sounds rough. I can't think of any piece of media I love that much.
I think that's what we should do next, and it should be Problem Child.
How about part two?
It's not a
Problem Child 2.
The vomit scene takes at least five episodes.
How about that?
Ooh.
Mean Girls would be good.
Yeah.
Did you say Kindergarten Cop?
Ooh.
That's what you were saying.
I said that.
Part one or two, though.
That's what you're trying to say.
Yeah.
I didn't mean to.
Final thoughts around the table. Adam, go.
Halloween is great. Ooh. I'm glad Melissa's here. It's fun to have her. I want Josh to podcast again. And, yeah. I don't like Freddy, and I love pumpkin spice. Boom. That's my closing
JP!
Statement.
JP!
Make sure to get your dogs neutered and spayed.
Yours. I'll go late. I'll go last.
No. I got to go last.
Well, you can go last, Mel.
Okay. Thanks for having me, by the way.
Yeah. Oh, it was fun.
This is super fun.
Yeah.
Halloween rocks. It's my favorite. So, yeah. That's it. Boom. That's all I got. That's my time.
And you hate Chucky.
I'm here all week. Also, I hate Chucky.
Yeah.
I do like Hocus Pocus, though.
Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, love that.
Yeah.
The clown has no penis. That's all I got to say.
What?
All right. We got this. Happy Halloween.
Boom. There you go.
Oh, it's so sad. It's over. That's it for Halloween 2018. That's all we got. That's all we got in the tank. There's nothing left. There's no more we can give. We've talked about Psycho this year. We've talked about Scream. We've done plenty of Adam's Ghosts. I think all the way back, there was even way back in August, there was like a sneaky Adam sneaking in a Halloween show under the guise of something else. But that's it for this year. That's all we've got for the Halloween. So I'm sure we'll crank up Halloween 2019 about a week earlier than we did this year. Or we could go all year, which is what we're going to plan on doing. We're going to take a little break from the Halloween creepy stuff. But very soon, just in time for Thanksgiving, we're going to begin every couple of weeks doing some creepy content. We used to do it on the show when we did two shows a week. It was called Creepy Tuesday. And every Tuesday was dedicated to something creepy. We're kind of bringing that back. And we're calling it Adam and JP's Long Halloween, coming very soon to Podcast Roll. Don't have an exact date yet, because Adam and I haven't figured it out. But it is coming very soon. Make sure you find us on Twitter at Adam and JP, on Facebook, facebook.com/AdamandJP, AdamandJP.com. You can contribute to the Patreon page, throw $1 a month in over at patreon.com/podcastroll. And please, please, please help others find the show by rating and reviewing the show on Apple Podcasts. Click over there and give us a 5-star review. It would be greatly appreciated. For Adam, for Josh, for our very special guest for the Halloween Super Show, Mel, I am Jay Patrick, wishing you and yours a very happy Halloween. And eat your podcast a roll.
Immortal can resist the evil of the flesh. Ha 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 ha!